I got tired of all the madness. I got tired of being a badass all the time. It's only survival, only not dead upon arrival, only ahead of every rival that we find. And we've ridden beyond where we could safely touch down. And we're out in the void past where we could have had turned around. I tried my feet on the floor, tried to beat on the door, but it didn't even make a sound. Got my heart open wide, but the city been shut down. It's easy to go, babe. It's just an easy yes or no, babe. It's just an easy way to throw away what we have. I don't need a letter. I don't need anybody better. I don't need anybody ever. I never have. And you're ridden beyond where you could safely touch down. And you're out in the void past where you could have had turned around. Told you before, I needed you more, but you didn't even turn around. Got my heart open wide, but the city been shut down. Revelator on every floor. Now how can I get it right? I don't even like what I write. I don't even like what I like anymore. But I stand in the yard and watch the evening come down. And I shuffle the chords when all the idiots come around. Told you before, I needed you more, but you didn't even turn around. Got my heart open wide, but the city been shut down. Hey, I told you before, I needed you more, but it didn't even make a sound. Got my heart open wide, but the city been shut down. Got my heart open wide, but the city been shut down. I got my heart open wide, the city been shut down.
Performed in front of an audience at World Cafe Live in Philadelphia, that was Revelator from Phosphorescent. It's the title track from Phosphorescent's new album. I'm Raina Douris, and Matthew Houck of Phosphorescent joins me today. Matthew, welcome back to the World Cafe.
Thank you for having me.
There's a line in that song, I don't even like what I write. I don't even like what I like anymore. It could be. It sounds to me, and I could be wrong, kind of like you might have been dealing with some writer's block. Is that true?
For sure, yeah. But also dealing with like a larger thing about you have these things that you believe in, I think, your whole life, and you love, or they give you, even without you knowing it, like you have these like go-to things that you rely on. And then sometimes those things all of a sudden don't do it anymore. It doesn't work anymore, you know, and it's always, it's a sad thing, you know. It's like a noteworthy, like, sort of shift, and you're like, well, what do we do now?
Yeah. The songs on this album, I mean, some of them, you can feel a little bit of that. You can feel some melancholy. You can feel, sometimes it feels like you're giving kind of worldly advice. Maybe you're feeling that melancholy about passage of time. You said yourself, earlier today, the album is a bummer, which I don't actually necessarily agree that it's a bummer. I think it, there are lyrics that could be read as a bummer. Musically, it doesn't really feel
I hope that's true. I hope that's true. I feel the same way, because I still trust in that mechanism that, you know, I've just, sad songs have always been the most important songs to me. And they're not sad that there's something else, even though they clearly are. But I guess what happens is like, yeah, look, there's a moment where you listen to a record or like listen to the record that you've just made or you're about to play a handful of songs for people. And it's very easy to truly question what it is that you're doing because, yeah, they're like, it's, you know, it's sad stuff. I don't know what the mechanism is or why to wallow around in this stuff. But I think that's what art does. It flips it around and you can, it gives you like a tangible way to like wrestle with this stuff. And you come out ideally sort of elevated by that.
Mm-hmm. I'm talking to Matthew Houck of Phosphorescent on World Cafe today. You've been a father for a while now. Now that your kids are getting a little bit older, how would you say fatherhood has changed you as a songwriter? Are there themes now that you're more interested in writing about?
Yeah, I think they're really inspiring people. Like I steal from them all the time. Like I lift lines from them that they say, and one of the songs on the record is a direct lift from my daughter's notebook that I found. It's a song called All the Same. It's called All the Same. And she had written this little poem about trees and how the ones with leaves and the ones without leaves, they're all the same. And like, it was somehow...
It was such a beautiful, profound line.
I know. And it really just struck me. And I was like, well, gosh, I think I have to maybe use that. So, I don't, yeah.
Okay, well, let's listen to a clip of that song right now. This is All the Same from Phosphorescent on World Cafe.
Leafy trees and empty trees, they're all the same. Trees and frozen trees, they're all the same.
That was a bit of the song All the Same. That's from Phosphorescent's latest album, Revelator. It's World Cafe. I'm talking to Matthew from Phosphorescent today. We're going to hear you play another song live in a second. And the imagery in this next song is really interesting. And the more I listened to this song and the more I read the lyrics, the more mysterious it got. Like, I felt like I was getting close to unraveling it, and then it would like slip through my fingers and I couldn't quite get there. What can you tell us about the song Impossible House?
That one is, I think, there's a couple songs on this record that I deal with some stuff that I think I needed to purposefully kind of maybe obscure it or something. Not obscure it. It's actually, I just think there's a, I didn't want to be too direct with that one. It felt too, it felt maybe too much. I feel like songwriting, you have to be that person. Like you can't, I think if you write a book or if you make a movie, you can, no one's assuming that you're directly saying something about you yourself as a person. Like you can, you're making some art, right? And I feel like I would like to have that freedom in song as well. It should be fun, even if you're dealing with some harder stuff, I think. But I think that song makes a weirdly perfect amount of sense to me, but I totally understand why it might not. Yeah,
I mean, you can pick up on, if you listen to this next song, you'll pick up on a Home Alone reference. There's a license plate that says NSTY. I'm like, wow, it's like a puzzle. Even the idea of an impossible house is such a wonderful picture to paint. So you're not going to give me any clues. That's fine. Let's hear it.
Yeah.
We'll leave that one. Okay. Here's Impossible House, recorded live by Phosphorescent on World Cafe.
Mm-hmm. See the lines in the field as they curve away from you. As the roads go flashing by. They say the signs will reveal it, but they hardly ever do. I know that can't be right. See, I was steadily moving, but now I'm steady standing still. So clearly set up to fail, I have to wonder what you're after. I see the lake in the evening as it's dripping off your skin. And I try to hold it tight. Try to shake off that feeling, but it just keeps slipping in, like the day into the night. Hey, I've been seeing you suffering, and I see you suffering still. You have to take it apart, you have to make this matter. You have made an impossible. And I laid them out for you. Just a captain doomed to drown. I went and pulled the alarm and it played around the room. And you were laughing at the sound. Went to your palace and hid as the thieves approached the throne. Like that McAllister kid, you have been left at home alone. You have made an impossible house. 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 I seen your black limousine rolling slowly through the alley. All long and shiny and mean with a license plate that just says nasty. You have made an impossible house. You have made an impossible house. You have made an impossible house. You have made an impossible hell.
Impossible House, recorded live for World Cafe by Phosphorescent. I'm Raina Douris. The man behind Phosphorescent is here with me today, Matthew Houck. His new album is called Revelator. It has been a while since you've been on the show, and you've been up to all sorts of things. I want to talk about a few of them. Back in 2022, you embarked on your Full Moon project and recorded a different cover every month, released it on the full moon of that month. Could you tell us how you decided to do that?
Yeah, I had played a show in Key West, Florida, and was walking around with headphones on. I stayed down there for a couple of days to try to do some writing. The idea maybe just to start making the new record, feeling a little hesitant or reticent maybe is about actually making a new Phosphorescent record. And I was listening to this Bob Dylan song, like a later era Dylan song called Trying to Get to Heaven. And it was one of those, I probably listened to it 40 times. Like, I don't know. Like, it just like, just, I was like, well, I'll start that one over and just keep, you know, that you get these. And it was like, I don't know. And I just got this idea that songs matter. Like, I love, you know, I love it all. And like, so yeah, I was like, well, maybe there's a way to just release, just do these songs that you love and not worry about making another Phosphorescent record right now, you know?
Yeah. The moon part of that. I mean, I've talked to artists, a few artists on this show who feel a special connection to the moon, the power of the moon. I mean, Neil Young will famously like coordinate his recording sessions the moon. Yeah, cool. He's really intense about it.
Feel that.
Was there any kind of like creative connection you felt to the moon?
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, it was the night that I'm talking about walking around, it was December of the year prior to that. And it just kind of was, I was thinking I could just probably put out a song every month. And then it was just like, you know, the moon was there over the ocean. And it was like, there's what we're doing. Like, yeah, it'll just be guided by that. Not, you know, because then it was like, well, you put out the first of every month or something like that. But it was like, no, let's, yeah. So yeah, it very much felt like, you know, cosmically guided.
You're performing a song from Full Moon Project for us today. It's a cover of country singer Vern Gosden's 1993 song, Any Old Miracle. Here's what the original sounds like.
Any old miracle that you could send me down. Don't go to too much trouble, Lord. Whatever you might have around.
So that might not be a song or an artist that everybody who's listening recognizes right away. How did you discover this song?
I just have a distinct memory of my daughter was, I think, like 2 weeks old, and we were in our Brooklyn apartment. And I don't know how that, I really don't know how that song came into being, because I don't even know that I was listening to radio or anything at that point. I really don't, like, you know how you, Vern Gosden was not a guy in my canon of like, you know, I feel like I spent a lot of time with country music and all this, but he had sort of eluded me, and I honestly don't know how it came to me, but I just have this very particular memory of dancing around with her, and that song was like, it's a big one, it's a monster of a song.
Let's hear your live version of Any Old Miracle. This is Phosphorescent. Originally, this song was by Vern Gosden. This is live for the World Cafe.
I know it's late, and I sure do hate to bother you, but you know you're the only one knows what I've been going through. It's her keeping me up all night again, so I just had to call on you to ask a favor of a friend. Well, any old miracle, there's no need to send it around. You take a little bit of extra trouble, Lord. Be sure you send the right one down. 'Cause if I have to get old, that one miracle, any old miracle won't do. Oh Lord, I know so many others stand in need. You got troubles to attend to, and you got hungry mouths to feed. But listen to me, Lord. I don't mean to take too much of your time. Just send me that one miracle to heal this heart of mine. But any old miracle, there's no need to send it around. It'd take a little bit of extra trouble, Lord. Be sure you send the right one down. 'Cause if I have to get over her, I'll need some help from you. So just send me that one miracle. Any old miracle won't do. But any old miracle, there's no need to send it around. Take a little bit of extra trouble, Lord. Be sure you send the right one down. 'Cause if I have to get over her, I'll need some help from you. So just send me that one miracle. Any old miracle won't do. Just send me that one miracle. Yeah. Any old miracle won't do.
Phosphorescent originally recorded that cover of Vern Gossen's song Any Old Miracle for his Full Moon project. That version you just heard was recorded live for the World Cafe. Matthew of Phosphorescent is here with me today. I'm Raina Douris. The last song that we're going to hear you perform live today is from the new album, Revelator. And it's interesting because we've talked a couple times now about the weight that you feel when you're putting together a Phosphorescent album and owning that music and the freedom of when you're doing things that aren't for yourself. This song is the first song that you've ever released on a Phosphorescent album that was not written by you. It was written by your partner, Joe Shvornikov, who's also a singer-songwriter in her own right. You guys collaborate all the time. How did it end up on your album?
She had written this song. She had played it for me, and I thought it was probably the best song I've ever heard in my life. And then she made a record and didn't put it on there, which was a confusing move. And I, weirdly, I actually recorded it during the Full Moon Project time, thinking maybe I would cover her song. But as I recorded it, and it was just such a, it's just such a staggering song to me. And then it just immediately dovetailed into these other songs that I kind of had going when I realized I was about to make. And so it was just, I just asked her if I could put it on my record. Yeah, I think it's a tremendous song.
Well, dig into that for me a little. Why do you love it so much?
In her mind, it was kind of like a Randy Newman type song where there's like a wink, where it's like a really devastatingly heavy thing happening, but kind of a little bit of humor there. And I hear that in what she's doing, but I didn't hear it that way at all. I hear it as like a straight, just sort of gut punch of a song that is, you know, really laying it down pretty as hard as you can, I think.
And before we hear it, I just was wondering if you could talk about this song and what it's like to play it.
It was just it's a lonely record, I feel like, is what. And I feel like it's okay and you own up to this stuff, but yes, I guess what I mean is it feels fairly insane to expect that people would want to listen to these things. You know, like just like sort of do, put that out there. But yeah, like that song, yeah, it's like, it's sad stuff, but I don't know. There's a beauty in it, but also, yeah, I have doubts about it.
Often. I think that people, you know, when there is, right now, there is like an epidemic of loneliness, they say, right? Mm. People, I think, want to hear things. I think that hearing your loneliness might make them feel less alone. You know what I mean?
This is what I'm saying. Yeah. Is this how it works?
I think it is how it works.
Yeah. Isn't that weird though?
It is weird. Yeah. Well, let's listen to this song performed live on the World Cafe's Phosphorescent, The World is Ending.
Like a California woman with a global point of view, you wear it well, it's unbearable. You found it in Peru. Well, 5 stars, great, you got it made. I've been reading the reviews. It's a new world, babe. I can't behave as if I know what to do. 'Cause I belong to an older song. It's a feeling unrelenting. And I might have apologized, but I have never been wrong. I know the world is ending. Your birth inspired spontaneous choirs, angels heralding you. The psychic's vision came to pass, the critics all withdrew. The palm leaves laid for you to play on, they sway as you come to. And all of this new happiness makes it all the more uncouth that I belong to an older song. Unrelenting. And I might have apologized, but I have never been wrong. I know the world is ending. Until they send some scientist to come and prove me wrong.
Is Ending, recorded live for the World Cafe by Phospherescent. It's a song from the new album Revelator. Matthew Houck of Phospherescent has been my guest today. Thank you so much for being here with me. I've really enjoyed this conversation.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
I got tired of sadness. I got tired of all the madness. I got tired of being a badass all the time. It's only survival. Only not dead upon arrival, only ahead of every rival.